All right, everybody, here we are here at Indianapolis getting ready for the TBL Draft Combine. As of right now, today is the day that I will do the podcast. We got a special guest today. And tomorrow, February 27th, will be the first day of the Combine. So I'll let you guys know that. Should be some fun. A lot of new talent, a lot of new teams. So a lot of these guys are going to be, you know, out there working hard, trying their best to try to impress some of these owners and coaches. So it should be fun to watch for the most part. So 27th through the 29th is when it's going to be going on. And make sure you guys stay tuned for that. And for more information, make sure y'all go to thebasketballleague.net. for whenever another tryout is or another workout. So just make sure you guys stay tuned in on that. And today we have a special guest in. Real great guy. Came, watched the Undiscovered League and the Summer League. Got his own business, his own team. So we're going to go ahead and welcome him in. And we're going to talk about some good stuff. Come on in, Chris Allison, everybody.
Yeah, there should be more applause. There should be a lot more going on. How we doing, man?
How you doing, Chris?
I'm doing fantastic. I'm doing good. We had a long day of meetings with all the team market owners, and so I'm anxious to not be in meetings anymore. Yeah, so glad I get to talk now.
So yeah, we're gonna talk, relieve some of that stress that y'all had to go through today. So,
yeah.
My first question is for you. How do you feel about the season this year? Are you excited?
Oh, I'm always excited. I love sports. And so I'm excited about the opportunity to be able to impact the community, be able to give opportunities to guys to be able to play basketball. Obviously, it goes without saying this year is unique with all the stipulations and everything that's going on. And some of the stuff that came up inside of the team market owners meeting was deciding how we were going to approach that. And we talked about the COVID protocol a little bit, and we talked about some other stuff. So I think the biggest thing that I'm excited about is the opportunity to play. We had 12 teams last season. We ended halfway through the season. I'm a little biased because my team was number one, and we would have looked good there at the end. But now with 35 teams, it makes it a little bit different of an approach and of an opportunity. Smaller pods, so there's not as much travel. So I'm excited about the opportunity and the prospect of what this could be, especially in the middle of COVID pandemic, whenever other leagues just aren't playing. Mm-hmm. And if we're smart about it, we can actually persevere and do well.
Right. So that's good. Like you said, your team last year, y'all were number one. Y'all had a chance at winning it. But this year, you know, you got two more teams.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you feel about those teams, and how do you kind of occupy managing those organizations?
Yeah. So last year I did have the Indy Express and I had the Owensboro Thoroughbreds. Mm-hmm. I was a first time team market owner. I hadn't owned any sports organizations. I run sports leagues, I run sports programs, but never a professional basketball team.
Right.
I own businesses and run those. And so applying those same principles to the basketball organization has done well with that. Now, last year, the Indy Express was a brand new team. And so starting from scratch was difficult as far as the fan base, not so much the team. The guys that play on the team, they did really well. They've been playing together for years. They live here in Indy. So it made it a whole lot easier.
Right.
Owensboro was a little bit different. You know, last year was the third year of the Owensboro Thoroughbreds. There was a previous team there. And some of the branding and some of the team recognition wasn't as great. So that was a challenge trying to go through. And then this year with the Atlanta Empire, it's an interesting thing. I purchased the team before I'd ever been to Atlanta. So that was interesting. And so I went there a couple weeks ago for the first time and met some incredible people. So I'm really excited about the prospect of Atlanta and what that's going to become. I think that it'll become one of the best markets under M1 Sports Group, just because of the people that we've met and that have already started working on that. So I'm excited about all those. How I manage it, I have great people that work for me. Owensboro, the Owensboro story would not have happened without Coach Anderson. Coach Anderson, I will Every time I will go to bat for him and do anything that he needs just because he's a phenomenal person. And so he made that incredible. And then I have some new guys down in Atlanta. Our director of operations, Noah Brown, he's a FIBA agent and he works down there with the Undiscovered Leave, some player development to get guys overseas and into teams. He's a really great guy, really motivated about the process. Mm-hmm. And we have some plans going forward about that. And then Indy's a different animal. I mean, I don't know how else to describe that besides it's unique.
That's where we at, man. We in Indiana. So
yeah.
Your iClude brand.
Mm-hmm.
How did that sort of come about, or what made you get into it? Because I see it everywhere with the TBL, the mask we got, our jerseys, the combine jerseys or whatever. So
yeah,
how did you pretty much get into that?
It is weird walking around and seeing it everywhere. So I will say that we walked into the TMO meeting today and I just see it everywhere. And, you know, whenever you create a brand and you start a brand and you imagine what it can be, especially an apparel brand, because everybody's like, I started an apparel business. I start my own brand, which is not the mm-hmm. same, you know, manufacturing and developing, cultivating ideas, expanding what your vision may be for something and turning that into something is just unique overall. And to be honest, I didn't want to start an apparel brand. I have no desire to get into textiles and learning about different cuts and different layers and different fabrics. I had no desire to get into that. But mm-hmm. the reason I started Infinite Apparel is because it is a tool to be able to give jobs to the clients that I serve. So my primary business, Open Arms, is a business I started. Ironically, next week will be our 10-year anniversary.
Nice.
So that's a milestone I'm excited about. But Open Arms, what it does is it works with individuals with developmental disabilities. Mm-hmm. We do in-home care, vocational training, day activities, and Special Olympics programs. And I started Infinite because it was a way for individuals in our vocational program to be able to start working on a business of their own. So the apparel, the shirts, the sweatpants, the sweatshirts, the jerseys, all the stuff, the packaging, everything that we do with IA Global is performed by them. Yes, I do a lot of the designing and I really do enjoy that process. But the reason that this business has been built and the reason that it exists is to be able to give them jobs. And I've said to people multiple times, if the reason I got into sports was so I could guarantee that I had clientele for our apparel brand.
Mm-hmm.
If people aren't buying our apparel, I'm not doing sports. And so the easiest way for me to be able to do that is to be able to invest into more teams, to be able to invest in more leagues, to be able to get new partners, to be able to get that apparel. And I do that well. I do that by increasing our success in the on the basketball side.
Right.
And so all of it's connected, but the mission, my heart, my heartbeat, my mission, everything I do is revolved around Open Arms. And that's the reason I do what I do every single day. So
yeah, that's big. That's big. It's almost like a domino effect. One affects the other. So
absolutely.
That's really good. What are some of your goals this year in the TBL? I know you got three teams now, so all those teams. I know you. I don't know if you got a favorite or not, but what's some of your goals this year?
I'm absolutely not biased to any of them. I can genuinely say that. The difficulty, and I tried very hard to convince the league to be able to make the move, and I understand why they didn't do it, but I have two teams in the same pod. And so that makes it a little bit difficult because we play each other six times. And so that is a very difficult game to be in. Last year, the season mm-hmm. opener was Owensboro versus Indy, and I couldn't wear any of my gear because I couldn't be biased, especially in Owensboro. Yeah. I couldn't make that happen. And so, as far as being, favorite, my goals for this year is there's two teams per pod that make the playoffs. So my goal for this pod is for Indy and Owensboro to be able to make the playoffs. It's going to be extremely difficult against Kokomo. Kokomo has spent a lot of time developing their brand, developing their players, developing their program. So I think that they're going to be really competitive.
Mm-hmm.
And then obviously Atlanta making the playoffs, starting from scratch, not sure how we were going to go, not knowing anybody there, to be able to make the playoffs is going to be a huge run. And then obviously the end goal is always to win. As much as I am a philanthropist and do things for other people, I'm also a competitor at heart and I want to win. And I will win on and off the court and put the best people in place to be able to do that. So,
right. That's super cool. I totally understand, especially having three teams. I mean, you got a good chance regardless.
This is true.
You are, I already know you got a good chance, especially I know y'all got y'all draft picks today. So
mm-hmm.
you're going to be loaded. You already know you're going to be loaded.
Yeah, so. I'm anxious to see this pool tomorrow. You know, so Atlanta got the 8th pick. Mm-hmm. And then Indy, or Owensboro got the 24th, and Indy got the 34th.
Yeah.
So I already have the coaches searching searching who they want. So see? They'll be yeah, anxious to saying. Go.
Y'all, yeah. y'all on the
We're
job
on it.
Already.
We're on it.
So there's this kid out there, whether it's a kid or daughter or whatever, but they want to do what Chris Allison does, which, you know, you own your own teams. Got iClude, the open arms thing. So what is some advice that you can give to a person like that that want to do that thing or do what you did already?
Yeah. The number one advice I give to anybody is to follow your passion. And I know that sounds cliche, but it's legit. It doesn't matter. And I've spent a lot of time in the last couple of weeks talking about this is people, especially in this age of entrepreneurism, you know, you have a year off from, you know, COVID. And so people are looking at different outlets of income. Mm-hmm. And so do I start my own business? Do I do a side hustle? Do I do that? It doesn't matter what you want to do. You can make money off of it. Cool. So if you're passionate about something, mm-hmm. you're going to make money.
Right.
Depends on what your level of money is. Mm-hmm. So if you're extremely happy and you make $50,000 a year, or you make $500,000 a year and you're miserable, follow your passion, follow what makes you happy. Work, live within your means, stay happy, stay true to who you are. And that at the end of the day, it comes to you. I come from a very poor background. We grew up in a trailer. I don't want to get into my story because it doesn't matter. But my point is that my goal was not to make money. Mm-hmm. My goal is to make an impact. And by making an impact, I have been blessed with what I have.
Right.
And I've taken that money that I'm blessed with and reinvested it back into other people.
And that's what makes you happy.
Exactly.
Yeah.
100%.
I read this thing, on social media, and it was this guy. He was this man. I think he had like two boats or whatever, so-called. It was a story. So this man had two boats, and the rich guy came up to him and was like, "You use those two boats to fish, and we can ship this here and ship this here, and I'll make you a millionaire in a year." But this guy that already had the two boats, he was living life. He was having fun at what he does, like his two boats, spending time with his family all the time. But the other guy told him like, "You would need to make a sacrifice in order for you to be a millionaire in a year." But the man told him, like, "Why would I make a sacrifice? And I'm doing what I want to do already, and I'm happy about it." So, mm-hmm. like you said, you can have $1 million and be miserable, or you can make $500,000 or $50,000 a year and be happy.
Exactly.
That's your choice. So that's big what you said. I always do, you know, what you're passionate at and what you love to do. So playing a major role in the community, in the TBL, I know that's big for all of our teams. Us, especially the Lewisville Leopards, we do a lot in the community, or we try to do as much as we can, you know, just to impact a lot of young people to make the right choices in life. What's some things that your teams will be doing to make an impact in the community?
This year may be a little bit difficult. I know that, you know, some of the things that we've seen, especially with Lewisville, is you guys had done some packing, some food. I remember around the holidays, you guys did delivery. And so we definitely will do as much as we can. There are some things that we have planned in Owensboro that I can't share yet because they
everybody
would be really mad at me if I did. But we are as heavy as we can be in Owensboro. We are there. We're actually putting on a 3-on-3 tournament for 8th grade and down.
Nice.
All the way up into the season. So the guys coming into training camp are going to help ref, mm-hmm. Do the scores, coach the players. So we're excited about that. We have some stuff planned during the season. Our theme nights are going to really be able to get people in and be able to recognize people and do that. I know it may be a little bit difficult with COVID for us to be able to go into the schools like we were last year. We were in a school every single day doing stuff. But we've worked with local partners there to be able to do that. In Atlanta, we've partnered with some good sponsors who are in the healthcare group, and just the education of COVID is extremely important to them. And so we're working on some unique ways to be able to educate youth, especially in metro areas or low income areas, to be able to get the information that they need to not be scared mm-hmm. of, you know, COVID. I understand it is a virus. It is a thing, but there are ways to be able to avoid it and to be able to protect yourself. And so just getting that education to them. So, you know, it is taking each market and understanding what is the most going to be the most impact to them and setting that precedent. So next year, whenever we can make a deeper impact, we've already had that presence there and people know who we are.
Mm-hmm. Pretty nice. So Chris, that's pretty much wraps it up. That's all my questions, all I had to talk about with you. But it is one more thing we got to do before you go.
Okay.
We got to do rapid fire.
Okay. This is easy.
We got to do rapid
fire. I'm good on that.
So the first one.
Okay.
Your favorite NBA player and favorite TBL player?
Ooh, I would say my favorite NBA player of all time is Dwayne Wade. It's a toss up between him and AI. So yeah. Both of those guys. Mm-hmm. My favorite TBL player. That's a tough one.
I'm coming in hot, Chris.
To be honest with you, one of my favorite players to watch. Man, I can't do one because last year one of my favorite guys to watch was on Indy was mm-hmm. Joe Redick. I played for Liberty University, and the other guy was Todd Brown from the Condors. Sorry, Corey, I would say you, but you know, whatever. So other than that, yeah, those are the two.
Yeah. So what is your favorite song right now, currently?
Oh, damn. I'm sorry, I said a bad word. My bad. My favorite song right now. I'm going to be judged, I know, but I've listened to M just came out with the B-side collection of his Music to be Murdered By, mm-hmm. and Nat is just great for so many reasons. Just the lyrical breakdown of it, it's so good.
Good. Favorite movie of all time?
Inception. See, Inception. That one I know.
Inception. Inception is a good movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
And last but not least, I know it's going to be hard, but you got three teams. You got to pick one. Indy, Owensboro, or Atlanta?
What about them? What's the question?
Rapid fire, you got to pick one.
For what? With the best logo? I mean, Owensboro has the best logo, best jersey.
The team, you got to go win it all. You got to pick one.
Oh, if I had to pick one, I would say that Indy has the best chance to win it.
Indy.
Yeah.
All right, that's it, everybody. Chris Allison right here.
I'm in so much trouble.
Chris Allison right here. He gave y'all the rundown about everything, so. Thank everybody for listening. Make sure y'all tune in tomorrow. Tune in for another episode of the CYM podcast and Undiscovered podcast. And this is Michael Lenore, Chris Allison, and I'm out.
See ya.